哈利路亚，各位兄弟姐妹，大家晚上平安。
Hello, dear brothers and sisters, peace be with you tonight.
我们预备一颗清洁的心来聚会，来敬拜我们天上独一的真神主耶稣基督。
Let's prepare a pure heart to worship our true God in heaven, the Lord Jesus Christ.
同心默祷。
Say a silent prayer.
Amen. 奉主耶稣圣名开始晚上的聚会。
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we commence our evening service.
大家唱赞美诗64首。
We sing hymn 64.
真光领导。
The heavenly sunlight.
在这黑暗世界里面，需要真光来领导。
In this very dark world, we need the true light to guide us.
不只是在黑暗中才需要光。
Not only do we need the light in the darkness.
我们发现到，就算我们在敬拜聚会中，也需要真光领导我们。
We also discover that even during our service, our worship, we also need the true light to come upon us.
讲道的人需要圣灵的光、真理的光带领他。
The speaker needs the light of the truth and the light of the Holy Spirit to guide us.
因为一不谨慎，就会偏差，就会走样。
Should we be less aware and less watchful, we will deviate.
听到的人也要圣灵、真理、真光来带领他。
And the listeners to the sermon also need a true light to guide us.
一不谦卑，不顺服，就偏差了。
Should we be less humble and less submissive, we will deviate.
心不在真理上，心不在主耶稣身上，听到的道理都变了，都歪掉了。
Our hearts are not planted on the truth and are not planted on the Lord Jesus. The sermon that we hear will be deviated.
所以不只是在黑暗中，这个世界需要光，连聚会听到讲道都需要光来带领。
Not only do we need the light in this dark world, we also need a true light to guide us in our sermons and worship.
那我们祷告，求主祝福带领我们的聚会。
We ask the Lord Jesus to guide us in this service through our prayer.
特别我们在讲 讲这个启示啊，讲这个使徒行传的信息。
Especially when we examine on the message of the Acts of the Apostles.
所讲的一切合乎神的旨意啊，按照圣经真理来讲解。
That all that is going to be spoken be according to the truth of the gospel.
一起祷告。
Let's pray together.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告，哈利路亚！感谢赞美主耶稣，哈利路亚！Hallelujah, 感谢主耶稣 Amen. 奉主耶稣圣名正道
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
主所亲爱的大家晚上平安
Brothers and sisters whom the Lord Jesus loves, peace be with you.
靠着圣灵的帮助
By the help of the Holy Spirit.
我们继续来分享来见证在风雨中前进
We continue to share and testify how we march forward in times of storms.
上一次我们看到彼得看见异象。
The last session we were talking about how Peter saw a vision.
这个异象特别是给彼得看的。
And that vision was meant for Peter's eyes only.
那么他看到一个大布从天降下来。
And he saw in his vision that a big cloth descended from heaven.
这个大布还记得那是预表什么？还记得吗？
Do you still remember what does this cloth represent or prefigure?
然后呢，大布里面又装了什么东西呢？
And what is contained within this cloth?
那么里面所装的各种活物，那又是预表什么？代表了什么呢？
And all these creatures that are in this great sheet or cloth, what do they represent?
他不单只看到异象，还听到主耶稣跟他说话。
Not only did he see this vision, he also heard the voice of the Lord Jesus.
其实不是说话这么简单啊，听到主耶稣下命令给他，主耶稣给命令他。
These are not just words from the Lord Jesus, but a command from the Lord Jesus.
主耶稣天上的声音告诉他说：“彼得起来宰了吃，叫他吃。”
And a voice from heaven came to Peter, "Rise, Peter, kill and eat."
他回答主耶稣说：“主说，主啊，这些不干净的活物，不洁净的，我是从来没有吃的呀。”
And Peter replied that, "Not so, Lord, for nothing common or unclean has any time entered my mouth."
那因为他不明白、不了解、也不能够接受，所以第二次又有声音、再向他解释。
That was because of his ignorance and he couldn't understand, and that's why the voice came to him again for the second time.
甚至也是有一种的很严厉的提醒他。
As a severe warning to him.
神所洁净的，你不可以把它当作住物。
What God has cleansed, you must not call common.
这个就不是跟他商量了，不是跟他解释哦。
This is no longer a negotiation.
这个是要他谨慎哦，要想好好来哦。神已经当作干净圣洁的。你不要乱来哦，你不要当作它是肮脏的哦。
This is for him to realize and to be alert that what has been cleansed by God shall not be called common.
那到第十六节说，一连三次啊，这种情形一连三次哦，这个异象这些东西才收回天上去。
And further on, we can see that this has been warning came to him for three times before this vision was taken away.
像我们的一个感想是什么呢？我们得到的教训是什么呢
？So what is this teaching that we are going to study?
当你不明白的时候呢，一些异象、一些神的启示呢，神跟你解释。
In certain visions that you cannot understand, the Lord God will explain to you.
你再不明白，神在第二次的再跟你解释清，再跟你的更清楚解释。
And you are still unable to understand the second time, the Lord God explained to you the second time.
甚至不是解释，指出你的错误，神已经当作干净的，你不要再啰里啰嗦。
Not only,
指出你的问题出来。
Not only did the Lord Jesus explain to him, he also pointed out his mistakes.
那你还是不接受，还是在怀疑。主耶稣就不再跟你解释了。
If you still do not accept and if you still doubt, the Lord Jesus will not explain anymore.
你看到第三次哦，就说第二次他还是拒绝哦，所以才要第三次嘛。
And we can see that the Lord Jesus explained to him the second time, and he still rejected.
到第三次的时候，你还不接受，还在主耶稣就把他收上去了，不再跟你讲了。
And when this was done the third time, then the Lord Jesus will explain no longer. The vision was taken back.
那这样的结果，这样的告诉我们就是。你要就顺服，你不能你就反抗，你就不听，就是这两种情形而已。
And the moral of the story is that we will only have these two outcomes: that either you submit or either you resist.
你不要以为我在这里，我在这里跟你有完没完的一直在讲，没有这样的事情呢。
And you have no time to negotiate with God all this all the time.
你就明白为什么我说主耶稣是下命令。
And this is why I said that it was the Lord's command.
这个不是在跟你商量东西，你知道吗？在跟你讨论东西，你知道吗？
It was not a dialogue, it was not a discussion.
你看主耶稣讲话就是命令啊，起来宰了吃，没得好解释的，起来宰了吃就是要你吃。
And you see the words.
这个是一种命令啊，要你做的事情啊。
The words of the Lord Jesus Christ came in as a command, rise and kill and eat.
请问命令需要跟你解释的吗？
So can I ask you, do I have to explain to you what is commanded?
如果这次命令需要跟你讲一次、两次、三次、四次这样讲的吗？
Should a command be reiterated to you or explained to you the second time and the third time?
如果要这么多次的，那不叫做命令了咯。
If you need so much explanation, that is not a command at all.
你跟你的工人，印尼工人也好，菲律宾工人都好，你叫他去洗车、去扫地，请问你需要跟他解释吗？
You ask your foreign workers to please clean up the place, and do you have to keep explaining to him why?
然后你需要跟他讲几好几次。 他才愿意做这样的工人吗？
And that you have to keep instructing him for a few times before he can finally do it.
所以有一些情况哦，讲一次你不明白，两次再讲，第三次就够了，不要再来了。
And so there's in certain cases where the second time and the third time has been explained, then you shall receive no more explanation.
因为神的话是权柄来的，其实一次就够了的。
Because the words of the Lord God are full authority, and you only need one time.
就好像为什么外教会不要举办洗脚礼，你知道他的理由是什么吗？
Do you know why the Christian denominations outside do not want to conduct feet washing sacraments?
他们其中一个理由就是说，这个不重要啊，如果重要，主耶稣一定讲好几次啊，圣经已经最少要记录好几次啊。
One of the reasons is that this is not important because the Lord Jesus only mentioned it once in the Bible, and otherwise it should have been repeated a few times.
你看圣经就是这样，腓立比书十三就是那一次，然后没有了。那证明不是很重要的，重要的主耶稣一定交代好几次的。
The only record that you can find in the entire Bible is the Gospel of John chapter 13, and it should mean that it is not important, otherwise it should have been recorded a few times.
这个就是他们的 不尊重神的话，不相信神的话。神的话没有权威的一个证明啊，没有权柄啊。
These are their argument and their words of unbelief, thinking that the words of God have no authority.
有权柄的，如果是个命令，王下命令也好，军队将军下命令也好，一次就够，不需要第二次。
Should the words of God be with authority, his command should only be given once, and that's sufficient.
所以我们大家要注意哦，有时是主耶稣跟我们讲，吩咐我们。有时是劝导我们，但是有时是一种命令，你要注意这个关键性。
Take note that sometimes it is God may comfort you, may exhort you, and sometimes command you.
那你不要用这个说，那人家传福音啊，传一次、两次、三次不听，不要理他哦。传福音不一样哦，因为传福音不是下命令，知道吗？
But you must not take this as an excuse to say that I have preached to this person for a second and a third time and I will give up right now because it's not the same as preaching the gospel.
传福音是跟人家分享福音的好处，把好信息带给他，让他去思考，让他去体会，让他去明白，让他去慢去接受，不是下命令的嘛，那不一样哦，你不要把它困在一起谈哦。
Preaching of the gospel is to preach to him this glad tidings to help him to understand, to examine, and also to think about it. And this is different from commanding from God.
这是我们从十六节哦，一连三次，主耶稣就不再多说了，也不再跟他啰嗦了，意象就消失。提出的教训跟思考。
And these are some of the teachings and the points that we can ponder over in verse 10, that after it was done three times, that all was drawn back again into heaven.
那么这一项收回去过后，那彼得的反应怎么样呢？彼得在接下来的情形又是怎么样呢？
After this vision was being drawn back up, and what happened to Peter?
我们请读17节到23节。
Let's read from verse 17 to verse 23.
请念。
Verse 17. If therefore God gave them the same gift as he gave us when we believed on the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I could withstand God? 18. When they heard these things, they became silent, and they glorified God, saying, Then God has also granted to the Gentiles repentance to life. Verse 19. Now those who were scattered after the persecution that arose over Stephen traveled as far as Phoenicia, Cyprus, and Antioch, preaching the word of God, preaching the word to no one but the Jews only. Verse 20, but some of them were men from Cyprus and Cyrene, who, when they had come to Antioch, spoke to the Hellenists, preaching the Lord Jesus. Verse 21, and the hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number believed and turned to the Lord. Verse 22, then news of these things came to the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent out Barnabas to go as far as 十章，
啊
，I'm sorry，
你读到哪里去啊？
十一章。
为什么你们这么久才讲呀？我的天哪、啊！没关系了，不用读了。
Chapter ten, let's read chapter ten. Please read it on your own.
那么意象收上去过后呢，我们看到彼得他的反应怎么样？他的状态是如何？
And after the vision has been taken back, what happened? What was the reaction of Peter?
十七节
verse 17.
这里说彼得心里正在猜疑啊，猜疑刚才那个异象。
Verse 17 here it says that Peter wondered within himself what this vision meant.
那第二呢，他根本不知道所看的异象是什么意思。这里说他不知道呀。
And secondly, here it told us that he did not understand what this vision meant.
其实主耶稣不是讲很清楚了吗？
Didn't the Lord Jesus make it very clear?
天上的声音对他说：“你起来宰了吃啊！”这很清楚啊，就是叫你吃啊。
That there was a voice from heaven that says that rise and kill and eat. This is very clear.
第二呢，你好，神已经当作洁，好，已经洁净了的，你不可以再当作是俗物啊。
And secondly, that what has been cleansed by God, you must not call common.
可是他不知道整个内容是指外邦人啊，神要接纳外邦人，他不知道。
But what he did not understand was that the content of this vision was for him to accept Gentiles.
想起来哦，主好，福音要传给外邦，接纳外邦人，不是现在这个意象才知道的，不是的。
In fact, that the gospel have to be preached to outsiders, to the Gentiles, should not have been revealed only in this vision.
难道主耶稣现在才告诉彼得啊，使徒们说现在要传福音给外邦人吗？现在才讲吗？
Was this a new command that the Lord Jesus would command the apostles to preach to the Gentiles? Is this new?
主耶稣还没有升天的时候，就不断地告诉他们说，你们等候圣灵，圣灵降下来，你们要奉主的名哦，传福音，从犹大地、加利利，直到哦。撒玛利亚直到地极，就已经吩咐，讲了，又在讲了。
And it was before the Lord Jesus even ascended into heaven that was that they were already commanded that they have to preach the gospel, be witnesses unto the Lord Jesus across the region, unto Samaria, unto Judea, all these Gentile places.
不过他认为应该是他们认为所谓的撒玛利亚什么地极什么传到哪里是传给。世界各地的犹太人啊，他认为是这样。
And probably they only assumed that they have to preach to the Jews living in Judea, Samaria, and the ends of the earth.
如果真的是这样，那我们听道理听这么多年了，听耶稣讲道，哦，看耶稣行神迹，真的完全不了解主的心意哦。
If it was actually the case.Then it goes to show that the apostles have listened and have been with the Lord Jesus Christ for so long, and they completely did not understand the will of God.
现在得圣灵，有圣灵带领了，还不明白咩？
And now that they already have the guidance from the Holy Spirit, are they still unable to understand?
所以神哦，主耶稣特别给使徒们看，特别是彼得来看这个异象，是针对他们这些律法主义，不愿意改变，不愿意放弃这种成见。特别给他们看，特别下命令给他们的，是一种一道命令来的，你要遵从的。
Which is why this command came from the Lord God Himself that their mindset under the law has to be changed.
嗯，其实现在的情况也是这样啦。有时道理讲这么清楚啊，又圣灵祷告这么久，还是心里猜疑，不知道什么意思，还是这样的情形，现在都是一样的呀。
And in fact, it goes the same way for us today that we have to understand this.
好，那么接下去说，他正在思想这些事的时候呢，十九节
，verse 19，
圣灵哈、哦，在思想的时候，圣灵对他说话，圣灵对他做见证。
While Peter thought about this vision, the Holy Spirit testified to him.、
这里让我们看到，当我们不明白神的意象时，不明白神的旨意时，要靠圣灵来指示你，圣灵就对他说，指示他，启示他，带领他。
From here we can see that as we do not understand the word of God, the Holy Spirit will guide us, and we will need the Holy Spirit to guide us and lead us.
嗯，但是哈，重点是他一直在思想那个意象啊，到底什么意思嘛？在思想神的话嘛，思想神的旨意嘛，圣灵就跟你讲，圣灵就带领你。
The point here is that Peter was thinking about a vision, about what it meant, and then the Holy Spirit came in to guide him.
这也是我们哦查考圣经、准备道理的时候的一种经验来的。进入神的话语里面去思考的时候，真的突然间好像明白了一些事情，突然间看到了很多很多内容出来，哦，神要我们讲的东西出来。
This is also what we experience when we do an in-depth Bible study, that we will be able to understand more and more teachings that are unveiled from the Bible.
所以我再重复一次哦，正在思想那个意象的时候，圣灵就跟你讲话，圣灵就带领你。
Let me repeat to you this point that as we are thinking about this vision, then the Holy Spirit guided him.
好，那跟着呢，圣灵吩咐彼得啊要做的几件事啊，吩咐他几件事情呢？
And later, the Holy Spirit instructed him a few matters.
第一，有三个人要来找你。
Firstly, three men are seeking you.
这真的还是假的？
Is this true or not?
如果来的只有两个人，那怎么办？
What if there were only two persons coming in?
啊，如果来的都是四个人，不是三个人，多一个人，那怎么办？
What if there were only there were four men but not three men?
哎，你不要说这个是小事哦。如果是多一个或者少一个，那圣灵讲的话就不准哦。圣灵讲话不飘准的哦。
Don't think that this is a small matter because it has to be very accurate whatever the words of the Lord, Holy Spirit says.
这些细节都很重要，三个就是三个， 就没有再多一个，也没有少一个，三个就三个，两个就是两个，是就是，不是就不是，那种原则，这个重点在这里，不是说哎呀少一个也没关系啦，多一个人呢也无所谓，不是，圣灵讲话不绝对不会这样的。
All these details are very and extremely important and accurate, that the words of the Holy Spirit have to be a yes or a no on a principle of accuracy.
这是我们要注意的事情哦。
This is something that we have to take note.
第二件事，圣灵叫他起来。
Secondly, the Holy Spirit instructed him to arise.
起来就是要他有所行动，不要在那边祷告，不用再跪在那边了，就起来就是一种行动。
This means an action that he has to take.
第三件事叫他下去，从楼上下到楼下下去。
Thirdly, go downstairs.
下去就是你离开你楼上那个环境，离开那个环境那个地区那个地方。
That's for you to depart from your earlier context or environment.
第四件是什么
？What's the fourth?
圣灵叫他做什么
？What did the Holy Spirit instruct him to do?
和他们就是那三个人，和他们一同前往，一同回去，回去撒玛利亚，回去。该撒利亚
to go with them, to go back with them, these three men to Caesarea.
这个圣灵特别叫他，你一定要跟他们一起走哦，一起去哦，你不要自己去哦。我不是要你自己去哦，我是要你跟他们一起去哦，请注意哦。
This is by specific instruction of the Holy Spirit that he had to go down to Caesarea with these three men, but not alone.
请问这些重要吗？传道，你讲这些东西重要吗
？So preacher, how is this important to us?
兄弟，不是传道讲这些圣灵讲的话，圣灵说你要跟他们去，不是传道讲的，所以当然重要喽。
So, dear brethren, this is not the words of the preacher, but the words of the Holy Spirit, and that's why it is important.
你知道为什么要这样讲吗？
Do you know why it is spoken this way?
因为他们是外邦人。
Because
其中有一些是罗马人来的。
Because they are the Gentiles, and among which are also the Romans.
彼得有一点不太愿意跟他们一起走了。
And in fact, Peter would be reluctant to walk with them.
圣灵知道他的意思，知道他的心很为难。圣灵特别交代你跟他们一起去。
The Holy Spirit
你不要自己跑哦，你不要自己去哦。
Knew the heart of Peter that he would be reluctant, and by specific instruction that he had to follow them along the way.
圣灵把内心的东西看到清清楚楚，还没有做出来，还没有讲出来，还没有去拒绝，圣灵就先讲给你听。你不用讲，你不用拒绝，你不用讲这么多理由，你跟他们去，已经先公开讲出来。
The Holy Spirit knows us inside out, and even before we make any excuses, and the Holy Spirit already put forth his specific instructions.
圣灵讲的第五句话，第五件事。
The fifth matter that the Holy Spirit spoke.
是什么呢？
What is it?
不要怀疑，不要再怀疑了。不要疑惑。
Doubt nothing.
那等于说他还是在疑惑咯。
Which goes to say,
那个心哦，上上下下，上上不懂怎么办的咯。
Which meant that Peter was actually full of doubt.
不要再疑惑了啦。
And here it tells us doubting nothing.
难道还讲不清楚吗？还不明白吗
？Is it not clear enough that you still don't understand?
既然这样，圣灵讲第六句话。
Then the Holy Spirit said the sixth matter.
圣灵说，他们这三个人是我差派他们来的啦，这样够了没有？
The Holy Spirit now explained to you that for I have sent them. Is this reason good enough for you?
二十节，是我叫他们来的。
Verse 20, for I have sent them.
那个这句话的意思，圣灵亲自自己做见证，你不用再怀疑了啦。不是他们自己来的，也不是人家叫他来的，是我圣灵叫差派他们来的。
These very words of the Holy Spirit testify to us that these three men are sent by the Holy Spirit, but not by anyone else.
主耶稣在天上跟他解释了好几次，一连三次。
The Lord Jesus had already explained to them before he ascended to heaven.
真的圣灵跟他讲话又讲了好几次，不断的跟他讲到说，最少我看到六句话呀。
And the Lord God actually explained to him three times in this vision, and also together with these six matters that the Holy Spirit instructed them.
讲这么多了，圣灵的见证这么多了，二十一节，于是彼得才下去啊，于是。
So much had been spoken before Peter finally went down.
不过感谢主了，至少。这时候彼得还是顺服圣灵嘛，于是他就下去了，那就是顺服接受了嘛。
But we thank God indeed that Peter at least finally submitted and obeyed the will of the Holy Spirit.
这样看起来，我们今天有没有顺服圣灵呢？
But this reflects upon us, and do we obey the will of the Holy Spirit? Do we submit to the movement of the Holy Spirit? Or do we accept the rebuke from the Holy Spirit? Perhaps it is easy for us to receive the or accept the comfort from the Holy Spirit, and sometimes the Holy Spirit rebukes us, but not just to comfort us.
那你接受吗? 你顺服吗?
Then do you then accept?
这里说, 彼得一试下去了,接受了,啊,顺服了。
Verse 21 here tells us, then Peter went down with obedience.
跟着呢,彼得到门口了,就见到他们,就跟他们说,请他们住宿嘛,23节,请他们住宿。
Now Peter came to the house and said, and
23节。
And in verse 23, invited them in so that they could lodge in with them.
圣灵是交代你跟他们一起去，圣灵没有交代你说再住多一个晚上，知道吗？
The Holy Spirit instructed him to follow these three men down this journey, but did not instruct him to lodge in with them.
不过你也可以说了，圣灵也没有说不可以住多一晚啊，明天再走，圣灵也没有说呀。
Then you can also argue that the Holy Spirit also did not tell him not to lodge in.
你要看他的结果，你要看他后面的情形。
But you have to reflect on what was the consequence.
好，他彼得为什么要给他们住宿多一晚呢？
Why did Peter have to lodge in or stay with them one night?
那时正在正午十二点，那还有时间嘛，还早嘛，还有大半天，大白天还有大半天。
Because he tells us that it was only 12 p.m. in the day, and he still had another half a day to go.
他是第二天，比如说今天是星期二，哦。 这三个人来找，圣灵跟他讲话，这三个人来找他，今天是星期二。
For let's just say that today is Tuesday, and the Holy Spirit instructed that these three men will come today.
那么他们到的时候是中午十二点，今天十二点。
And when they arrived, it was 12 p.m. Tuesday.
彼得搞到第二天星期三，才出门。
And after only on Wednesday that they started the journey.
但是星期三几多点开始走不知道。
But we have no idea what time did they start their journey the next day.
反正他星期四才到哥林流的家。
And as long as all we know is that they will only arrive at the house of Cornelius on Thursday.
星期二就到你的家了,叫你去了。 你搞到星期三才走,然后搞到星期四才到, 一共用了三天。
And the vision came to him, or the instruction came to him on Tuesday, and the three men already arrived, but you have to stay another night and until you are able to only visit or go to Cornelius on a third day.
你看那个哥尼流天使跟他讲的时候，那时候是傍晚了呢。
But you
know, 圣经说那是三点了呢，三点在讲这些话，在拿一些行李，弄到来四五点了，已经傍晚，已经是太阳下山，马上去，第二天就到了。比如说。 今天圣灵来启示说要去找彼得，今天星期二，他星期三就到了，星期三明天十二点就到了，看人家几快啊！
But you compare this,
一天就到了。
You compare this with Cornelius when the instruction of God came to Cornelius at 3 p.m. on the first day, and immediately he took action and he went in. He went in to meet Peter only in one day's time.
你不信，你看23节。
We read verse 23.
这里说。 请他们进来，次日才起身和他们同去，是吗？第二天才去，对不对？
Here tells us that on the next day, only the next day, when Peter only Peter went away with them.
第二十四节，又次日又在第二天，才进入该撒利亚，所以已经是三天了。
And verse 24, that only after on the following day, the third day, that they entered Caesarea.
所以就是啦，所以我就刚才跟你讲了嘛。 彼得有人说他有点在拖延啊。And
as I already
在拖啊，慢吞吞的拖。
Tried to explain to you that this is how Peter was procrastinating.
第一他是在拖了啊。Firstly,
he was procrastinating.
第二个理由就是他觉得不要在半路过夜了，因为你现在开始走，你一定肯定今天一直在半路晚上在路边过夜的。Or
perhaps the second possible reason was that he did not want to stay another stay elsewhere on another day.
有人解释他为什么要住宿，要请他们住宿然后才走，有两个原因。
So there are some scholars who try to explain why did he lodge in here for this two reasons.
一个就是路太远，一定要半夜晚上在路边过夜。
The first reason being because the journey is so long and they had to stay somewhere along the journey.
第二个有人解释说他在拖了，拖时间了。
And some other people also explained this way that he was only procrastinating.
这两个原因我都可以接受，都有事实存在。
And both these reasons can be reasonable because it is backed up with
facts. 其实我看到还有第三，我看到还有第三个原因。
But I can actually see the third reason.
他为什么要花这么多时间？
Why do you have to delay?
你看第二十三节，他去找谁？
Verse 23, who did he look for?
次日起身和他们同去，还有约帕的几个兄弟跟他一起去。他在找几个兄弟陪他一起去啊。
On the next day, Peter went away with them, and some brethren from Joppa accompanied him. This is what Peter went looking for.
你找人跟你去，你也是要去找，要时间去找，而且要有时间去给人家准备啊。
If you have to look for someone else to accompany you, and you still need time to do that.
那么这几个弟兄到底是几个呢？
So how many brethren are there here?
你会吓到哦。
You will be surprised.
找六个人陪他呀。
Six brethren.
哪里有讲六个人？
Where is it recorded?
请看十一章的十二节。
You look at chapter 11, verse 12.
11:12.
Chapter 11, verse 12.
圣灵吩咐我和他们同去，不要疑惑。同坐我去的还有六位兄弟，有没有？
Here it tells us, moreover, these six brethren accompanied Peter.
而且这六个人，他所找的六个人全部是律法主义的，是很强调律法的人。
And these six brethren happen to be those very law-abiding or very firm or very staunch Jews in the law.
你怎么知道呢？传道，你怎么知道呢？
So preacher, how do you even know that?
当然圣经讲的咯。
It is spoken by the Bible.
圣经哪里有讲哦？
Where is it recorded?
啊，你就看十章四十五节。
We look at chapter 10, verse 45.
十章四十五节。
Chapter 10, verse 45.
那些奉哥里和彼得一同来的那几个弟兄，就是。奉哥里和他，这六个人都是奉哥里来的、啊。
And those of the circumcision who believed were astonished, and they came along with Peter. These are the people of the circumcision.
所以你就知道为什么主耶稣要跟他讲这么多次，圣灵要跟他讲这么多次，他才好像很为难的这样答应。
And now you think back as to why did the Holy Spirit or the Lord Jesus explain to him so many times before Peter reluctantly agreed.
就算答应了呢，去了还要找六个奉行割礼、律法主义很强的六个弟兄跟着他去，要他做见证。哎，不是我一个人去的哦，还有六个行律法的人去的哦，不是只有我哦，他要找他们作伴啊，找他们做见证啊。
Even after Peter seemingly agreed to the instruction of the Holy Spirit, he also went through a trouble to look for six more brethren to be his so-called witnesses.
有事也不是我一个人啊，你看有见证人啊，他们都明白的呀，他们也跟我去啊，六个人啊。
And now it is not me alone, but I have six more witnesses with me who can understand this.
有需要这样做到这样的程度吗？
But do you have to go so far to do this?
或者你说找一两个陪你，那 OK 了，也明白。
Perhaps you
需要找到六个吗？而且全部是要奉行割礼的哦。
Perhaps you may need one or two more brethren to follow you, but you got six with you.
你知道这些奉行割礼的人都是很难接受外邦人的嘛？你都知道，那你为什么还带这么多人去？这么多这样的人去？
And these Jews of the circumcision, which also refer to those who are more staunch with the Jewish customs, and why do you get them along with you?
这就是我看到他拖延的第三个原因，第三个情形。
And this is a third scenario, a third reason why he was delaying.
彼得也好，那我们再继续看那个哥尼流到的时候，哥尼流的预备，他怎么样预备呢？
We continue to look at how did Cornelius prepare himself.
请看二十四节。
We read verse 24.
他们一到他家的时候呢，那个哥尼流已经请了他的亲戚、朋友、密友、好朋友在等他们了咯。彼得他们一到的时候，那个哥尼流的朋友也好、亲戚也好，全部在家等他们了。
As Peter and his people arrived, Cornelius already was waiting for them with all his relatives and close friends.
可见得这哥尼流哦，他是多么的用心安排，很紧急的、很紧张的在那边预备，在那边等候呀。
And we can see how sincere and how urgently Cornelius prepared for this.
你注意看哦，他们还没有进他家的时候，还没有到时候，这些人已经在那边等，已经在家里面等了哦。
Take note that before they even entered the house of Caesarea, Cornelius was already waiting for them with these people.
你却慢吞吞拖来拖了前后拖了四天了前后了。
And you were procrastinating and delaying for about 3 or 4 days.
你不信你看30节。
We read verse 30.
哥尼流说前四天这个时候我在家中祷告的时候突然间有天使穿着光明戒白天使来找我前四天前。就等于说已经花了四天了咯前前后后。
Verse 30 already tells us that Cornelius said that 4 days ago he was fasting until this hour, and that goes to say that he was already waiting with them 4 days ago.
可能这些亲戚朋友在家里等了两天了，你知道吗？
Perhaps his relatives and his close friends waited for 2 days already.
因为一天时间就可以到了的嘛，好像他都铺了一天时间就可以到了。但哪有想到拖到这么久啊，这么多天啊。
Because this was supposed to take only 1 day's journey, and yet it was being delayed for 4 days.
那时又没有电话说，主人啊，他们还没有预备好，还没有开，还没有，又没有电话好打的，那只好在那边一直等，一直等哦。因为我哪里知道你几时开始走啊？我哪里知道呀？
And now that they do not have any cell phones to call each other to update on their duration, and we wouldn't know.
哦，这确实是这样哦。
So this was the truth.
因为这个哥尼说我们已经在这里四天了，他说四天前就开始准备了。
Because as what is spoken,
就叫人家去请你了。
What Cornelius said that 4 days ago he was already preparing for this.
那今天我们看我们今天的聚会情形。
But now take a look at ourselves in our attitude to a service.
如果我们今天要听道理要来聚会有哥尼流这些这样的预备、这样准备、这样等候的心主耶稣很高兴主耶稣得到很大的荣耀。
If any one of us ever has this kind of attitude of Cornelius in preparing for this church service and worship, wouldn't the Lord Jesus be very pleased?
一个外邦人,
now look at this Gentile.
里面所住的, 所等待的, 所要听到的, 全部是外邦人, 没有一个是信徒, 没有一个是。
Together with his close friends and relatives who are all Gentiles.
就这么样的在里面等, 等啊, 等啊, 这么用心在等, 这么有心在等。
And they were waiting and waiting and waiting so earnestly.
等彼得来讲道理啊。
They were waiting for Peter to speak a sermon.
今天我们看我们聚会，是让主耶稣等呢，是我们在等主耶稣呢，还是主耶稣在等我们呢？
But now look at ourselves during our services, and are we waiting for the Lord Jesus, or has the Lord Jesus been waiting for you?
在我牧养过的教会里面，
in the churches that I have pastored,
曾经有八点钟聚会嘛，八点钟教会门还没有开。
And there was once one occasion when the church service was supposed to start at 8 p.m., but the gate of the church was not even open at 8 p.m.
当然我到了过后呢，这种情形就改变了啦。当然啦，他们说我这么凶，这么骂人，所以还敢不开门呢。
And after,
我之前的时候真的是这样。
And after that, as I started to pastor that church as a resident preacher, they were all afraid and they were all becoming more and more punctual.
我们全马嘛，全国就是晚上八点开聚会的嘛，拜五。
And in Malaysia,we all have night services starting from 8 p.m.
门还没有开，八点钟到了，八点了没有开，连长执事负责人都没有到了，等于说，是咯。
But the door of the church.
所以你不要讲信徒哦。
The door of the church is not even open at 8 p.m. and that would mean that even the persons in charge or the deacons of the church are not even there.
所以有时你们常说传道在讲，在骂人，传道在讲，你不要传道骂你，那你就看看我们的行为，你怎样对待主耶稣嘛？你看看我们怎样来聚会嘛？
And you like to complain how the preacher is always scolding you and rebuking you, but you take a look at yourselves and what is your attitude towards service?
另一种情形。
And another scenario.
门早早就开，七点半就开了。
The door has been wide open since 7:30 p.m.
等到八点十五分，一个人都没有来。
But the preacher has been waiting until 8:15. There's not even one person entering.
一个就是信徒到了门没有开，一个就是门很早就开了没有人到。
And the first case being I arrived, but the door has not even been opened. But the other, the door is wide open, but no one came.
你不要以为这是以前的事情哦，我跟你讲，现在还是在发生着的。
You don't think that this is some issues of the past. It is actually happening even now.
因为最近才有一个传道跟我讲啊，同工跟我讲啊，就是这种情形呢、啊。我说有这么离谱吗？我在的时候不是这样的、哦，他说你不在了吗？
This was being shared to me from the persons in charge of that church which I pastored, and I asked them, "Is this so ridiculous?" And yes, it wasn't so when you were here.
哎呀，我也觉得很伤心呐。
And it saddens my heart. Me.
在那边好几年没有办法真正建立起他们敬畏神。
When I was
一走就倒下来了。
For the short few years I was there, I wasn't able to build up their faith properly, and after I left, they collapsed.
你看人家，你看哥林流的亲戚朋友，你看一个都没有离开的，就在那边等啊，你还没有到，他们就在那边等啊。
Take a look at Cornelius and this Gentile of friends and also relatives that they did not leave, they were all waiting.
好，那么25节哈、
哦、，verse 25。
那么他们一进去了哈、哦，彼得进去哥林流就迎接他了，而且还俯伏在他的脚前来拜他哦。
When Peter was coming in, Cornelius met him and fell down at his feet and worshipped him.
哎，哥尼流是一个大官，是有权力、有权柄的人啊。
Cornelius was a governor, was someone with authority and power.
他是一个军官啊，他对他的手下、对他的军队讲，这样去就去，叫他来就来的呀。
He was honorable and respected by many servants.
你看一个大官，一个有权柄的人，你看他怎么样做，他多么的谦卑，伏在彼得的脚前哦。
Such a high-ranking officer was humble enough to fall at the feet of Peter.
不是俯伏在他的面前，俯伏在他的脚前跟俯伏在他面前是有差别的哦。
He did not
伏在他的脚前呢。
He did not kneel down before Peter, but he knelt down before his feet.
你看他心里多么尊重，当彼得是神的工人啊，神人啊，这样来尊重啊，这样的来敬畏啊。
His heart was full of fear and awe, to regard Peter as the worker of God.
然后还拜他呢。
And also worship him.
当然这个是不对啦。
Of course, that is not right.
可是你却看出他对神的仆人那种尊敬的神到这样程度呢。
But you can
虔诚到这样的程度呢。
But you can see to what extent did he honor and respect the worker of God?
尊敬神就一样会尊敬神的仆人、神的工人。
As he honored God, he would also honor the workers of God.
你说你尊敬神，你不尊重神的工人，那是有点不真实的啦。
If you claim that you fear God, you honor God, and you don't honor the workers of God, you are not true.
所以我们真的是有需要再看一看这样的圣经呢。
And we have to take a look at this passage again.
特别现在的年轻人哦，都不太尊重哦工人呐、啊。
Especially
态度上就是很不尊重啊。
Especially our youngsters today, we do not give enough respect towards the workers of God.
这是真实的事情，真实的现象。
This is very, it is a real scenario.
这是错误的，这是不对的态度来的。
This is a false attitude.
我们看《帖撒罗尼迦前书》，我这样讲就说哇，传道你要人家尊敬，不是我啦，就是反正是工人啦。你不要理啊，你不尊重我没关系，但是你要尊重其他的工人啊。
Please don't misunderstand this as the preacher wanted you to respect him, but it is our duty to honor and respect the workers of God.
因为圣经交代啊。
And the Bible has instructed us clearly.
就算圣经不交代你说你尊重神，你一定会尊重神的仆人嘛。
And even if the Bible did not instruct you specifically, you have to honor God and also his people, his workers.
帖撒罗尼迦前书五章。
We turn to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5.
我们读12节到13节。
We read from verse 12 to verse 13.
请念。
Verse 12. And we urge you, brethren, to recognize those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you. Verse 13. And to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake. Be at peace among yourselves.
这里说我劝你们要敬重那些在中间劳苦的人。
He tells us to recognize those who labor among you.
那么这些劳苦人就在主耶稣里面治愈我们的，管理我们的。
And these people may admonish you in the Lord.
劝诫我们的，你做错的时候，你走歪的时候，他劝你的，他甚至责备你的。
You do something wrong and he will rebuke you, he will admonish you.
第十三节。
Verse 13.
又因为他们的工，他们所做的工，你要用爱心哦。还要用爱心来格外特别的尊重他们。
And you have to esteem them very highly in love.
我在想，为什么要用爱心尊重他们？
Why, I was thinking, why must it be in love?
尊重他就尊重他嘛，为什么要用爱心尊重他？
You can esteem them, but why in love?
你可以解释吗？
Can you explain that?
我尊重这个长老，我尊重这个执事，那就 OK 啊，那就尊重他就好了。为什么要用爱心尊重他？
I esteem this elder or I respect that deacon and why should I do this in love?
当说要用爱心来尊重他的时候，爱心就是你的爱心嘛，要爱他嘛，就是他有软弱，他有亏欠的地方，他有不足的地方，你要用爱心去接受他，去包容他，这才叫做爱心啊。
When you are required to esteem a certain person in love, and that goes to mean that the other person is also full of weaknesses, and you will have to accept him and embrace him, even his shortcomings.
我以前也没有发现到这种细节啊。
I never thought of.
尊重就好了嘛，为什么要用爱心呢？
I never related this to such a detail, but it's simply that we have to esteem the other person.
所以十二节是敬重他们，尊重他们。那么十三节是爱加上爱心尊重，那么就是说有一些工人呢是有亏欠的，是有软弱的。
Now, verse
12, 就需要用爱心格外尊重。
Verse 12 tells us to recognize them and esteem them, and verse 13 tells us to be in love in esteeming them, and that goes to say that they even have shortcomings and weaknesses, and we still have to accept them.
那今天我为什么突然间讲到这点呢？
And today, why am I stressing on this point?
你看哥尼流这个外邦人怎样对待神的工人，你自己看呐、啊，你看他的态度，他的表现，哦，他的真诚，你看呐、啊，人家是怎样尊重神的工人的。
Take a good look at how Cornelius, this Gentile people, have respected and honored the worker of God, Peter.
我们回到第十章，使徒行传第十章。
Return to Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10.
我们看二十六节。
Verse 26.
二十六节呢，虽然是这样，但是我们看到彼得呢，他的侍奉呢，也是很谦卑，很警醒，谦卑而警醒。
Verse 26 tells us that Peter is also being watchful and humble.
哦，他没有因为这样，你看是个大官员呢，是个有权力的人呢，在众多人的面前，其他也可能是一些军官来的，他的朋友来的，在我面前这样来待我，哇，多有脸啊，多骄傲啊，多风光啊！他没有这样发烧啊，他没有这样来发烧啊。
Well, Cornelius was a high-ranking officer, and together with him were his relatives and friends who might also be of high status. And Peter did not claim this as his own glory.
Oh, 彼得马上拉起他说：“哎，你起来，你起来，我也是人呐、啊，我不是神呐、
啊，
我也不是什么神人呐、啊，我就是人来的呀。”跟你一样的。
Immediately, Peter lifted him up and said, "I stand up. I'm also a man."
这是彼得的谦卑跟他的侍奉的警醒的态度，警醒。
This is the vigilance and also the humility of Peter.
因为很多人在成功的时候，在众人的赞美的时候，在众人把你当神来拜的时候，你就迷失自己了。你简直就是迷失自己了。
And there are many people who are drowned in compliments and praises and honor, and you will have lost yourself then.
这个我们做传道工人的真的要非长职长老执事的要非常注意这一点。
And to workers and preachers and deacons and elders, we have to take note on this.
特别是我们哈受很多人爱戴来拥护的时候，来支持的时候。
Most especially when we have been loved and cared for and honored and respected.
一不警醒，你就会陷入这种迷失里去，骄傲里面去。
And just by not being careful for a while, and you will completely fall into the trap of pride and arrogance.
我讲过一个很悲伤的事情嘛。
I've told you something that was very saddening.
一个执事被安立成为长老了。
A deacon was being anointed to become the elder.
到乡下去啊，巡牧的时候。
And when he went on to the village.
那些老信徒哈，七十多岁的老信徒看到执事来，很高兴的叫他执事。这个执事很生气啊，你叫我长老。
Some elderly.
我就在旁边呢、啊。你要叫我长老，很大声的喊他。
And this elder was going into the village church together with me, and some senior members greeted him. Oh deacon, oh deacon! Then he immediately scolded him and saying that I am an elder. You call me an elder.
因为他感受到哦，信徒没有尊重他，没有叫他长老，就是不尊重他。他感受到这样。那但是信徒不知道你已经立了长老，他不知道呀。
And what he felt was that the members did not respect him as an elder, but the members simply did not know.
你又不是常常去，你好几年没有去了，你知道吗？
Because he was not a regular visitor to that village.
所以这些就是让我们迷失了。
And these are the things that would make us lose our way.
如果遇到这个大官员向你拜，把你当神来拜，你会怎么样？我看你会飞哦，你这个人会跌倒了咯。
If we had such a high-ranking officer or governor kneeling before us, and wouldn't you be floating with pride?
这个就是彼得，他虽然刚才我们讲他立法观念，那是另外一件事，可是他仍然是很谦卑、很谨慎的哦。立法观念是另外一件事情。
We did mention that Peter was a very compliant to the Jewish customs and laws, but this is another matter.
那他就开始讲话了，开始讲了。
And then Peter starts speaking.
二十七节哈。
Verse 27.
哦。彼得和他说话，好，说着话就进去。哇，见很多人在那边聚集哦。
He talked with them, and he went in and found many who had come together.
大家都在等彼得来讲道理啊。
Everyone was waiting for Peter to speak a sermon.
你看彼得第一句话讲什么
？What did Peter say first?
28节。
Verse 28。
第一句话见到面，大家说：“ 你们知道犹太人跟 别国的人跟外邦人是没有来往的哦。
Now you know how unlawful it is for a Jewish man to keep company with and with or go to another nation.
我们犹太人跟你们来往本来是不合列的，不合规矩的哦。
And now that you know that it is unreasonable for a Jewish man to be with Gentiles.
但神已经指示我，启示我要来了。
But God has shown me that I should come here.
你讲这些话来干什么？
Why do you have to even say this?
里面这么多亲戚朋友，这么多外邦人，想要听神派来的工人。你第一句话就说，我们跟你们没有来往的哦。
These are Cornelius' close friends and relatives, and the first thing that Peter said was these, that I am Jewish, I'm a Jew, and I should not have been with you.
还说是神叫我来我才来，如果不是那个意象，我意思说我根本不会来，根本我不会跟你们，不会跟你们见面的呀。
And he even specifically said that it is only by specific instruction of God that I would have come here.
彼得，你讲这个这些话你做什么？
So Peter, why are you even saying such things?
你是这么会讲道理的人，有恩赐的人。
You are supposed to be someone eloquent and gifted.
你讲道理有权柄的人。
You speak with authority.
你为什么第一句话对外邦人讲这种这么种族分哈，这种分得这么清楚的这种种族的话。
Did you have to speak such a racist or a racial sentiments?
后来我明白了。
Then I understood.
他讲给那六个人听的啦。
He was actually speaking this for the sake of the six brethren that came along. Do you know that?
我是表明我的立场哦，我没有跟他们来往的哦。我讲得很清楚，你们也听到的哦。
He was trying.
我一见面我就说我跟他们没有来往了，你们听到没有？因为这六个人要回去做见证的，你知道吗？去耶路撒冷做见证的。你后来你会发现到原来。他担心那些耶路撒冷的 那些人啊。
Then you realize,
他搞这么多事情出来啊。
Then you will actually realize that his intention was so that his Jewish brethren could witness this and understand to have this clarified.
但是也因为你这种、哦、保护自己、哦、一直要保护自己，你也是觉得，哎呀，你是神的仆人，你为什么这样讲道理呢？你为什么讲这样的话呢？很伤人家，知道吗？如果我是哥尼流啊，我有脾气，我有性格啊，这样不用了，谢谢你了，我们不需要你，老实讲啊，对不对？你既然讲得这么清楚，没有来往，有什么七七八八啊，那 OK 了，再见了。
Now, although Peter might have done this out of this intention, and yet this also demonstrated to him this unpleasant sentiment, and if Cornelius was someone with a bad temper, he would have rejected them all.
其实彼得可以讲，他是有讲到恩赐的人嘛，他很讲到有权柄很厉害啊，他可以讲哈利路亚，感谢神，今天我们到你的家是神的恩典啊，神的怜悯啊，神叫我们来以后把天国福音传给你们。主耶稣要见了，可以讲这样吗？大家都听得很高兴啊。
And Peter, with someone gifted with eloquence, should have said that, "Hallelujah, the Lord God has allowed me to come and visit you." And couldn't he say that?
所以我发现了彼得其实他是很厉害讲，他是有讲到恩赐的人，他应该知道怎么讲的。所以我说他是讲给那六个人听的。
Which is why I said that someone gifted with such eloquence, Peter could have spoken such words, and the reason why he said this was to testify to the other six Jewish brethren. Because assuming someone gifted with so much eloquence in speaking a sermon, and he wouldn't have made this mistake without his intention.
我们下次星期六四点半还会继续看彼得后来十一章的时候被人家质问你为什么去传福音给外邦人的时候，你看他的回答，你就知道了。
The next time we will study on Saturday, 4 p.m. 4:30 p.m. As to why did he speak this sermon to admonish them?
那么我们就结束吧。那么就30到33节哈。那么哥尼流就解释哈，为什么会请彼得来，是因为天使啊，是因为天使叫他的了哈。
From verses 30 to 33, Peter explained the reason why he was here was the angel guided him here.
看33节。
Verse 33.
所以天使一跟我讲过后呢，我立时哦，所以证明哦，3点多、4点多了过后啊，傍晚了，他马上就当天打发人家去请彼得，就在那个晚上，所以他的仆人哦，在半路上过夜的呢。肯定啊，他去的时候 都已经傍晚了，
and,
是在半路过夜，甚至没有过夜也赶了，就是一直赶路，一直赶路，都可能、哦。
And along his journey, he was always in a rush and in a hurry, and until when they arrived, it was already evening.
所以二三十三节，我立时打发人去嘛，就是马上嘛。 没有拖到明天哦。
Verse 33 tells us that he sent to him immediately without any delay.
所以哥尼流的话，听到神的话，看到异象，跟彼得看的异象，拖拖拖，你就有差别了。
Now we can see the difference in terms of the reaction of Cornelius after witnessing this vision and how he immediately did things, but Peter was delaying.
4点半我们接下去哦，讲到的时候，圣灵突然间降临。
And this coming Saturday service, I will share about how the Holy Spirit suddenly descended on them during the sermon. Because I thought that was a very strange thing. The sermon was not even finished. But the Holy Spirit descended on them so to stop them from speaking and they could start praying. So there was no need to speak anymore because you shall only speak in tongues.
你可以解释一下吗？为什么圣灵要这样做？
And can you explain why the Holy Spirit had to do that?
难道圣灵不能够等他讲完才降下来吗？
Couldn't the Holy Spirit wait a little longer after the sermon is finished?
这个是有趣的问题，你可以真的是可以思考一下的。
This is a very, very interesting question.
而且一定有他的教训跟提醒在里面。
And surely there is some teaching and reminder in it.
我们来唱诗。
Let's sing hymn.
63首。
Verse hymn 63.
哎呀，主耶稣带领我们嘛。
May the Lord Jesus tarry with us.
天国路有时会感受到很孤独呀。Sometimes
you will feel very lonely along your journey to heaven.
求神带领我们呐。We
ask the Lord to guide us.
一起祷告。We
pray together.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告。哈利路亚，感谢赞美主。哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚。 Hallelujah, 哈利路亚，感谢主耶稣，阿们。恳求救主永不离去，使我心安不忧虑，慈爱伸手领我前行，过黑夜达到光明。恳求救主永不离去，使我心安不忧虑，慈爱伸手引我前行，过黑夜达到光明。阿们。感谢主，阿们。感谢主祝福带领我们晚上的聚会。
Thank the Lord Jesus for His blessing and guidance in this evening service.
聚会到这里结束了。
Our service concludes here.
我们星期六四点半再继续。
See you again and continue on Saturday 4:30 p.m.
再见哦。
Peace be with you. Good night. 谢谢。